we refer to it as a Bundesverdienstkreuz, and it was founded by our first president in 1951, which is really the highest order that you can receive as a civilian in Germany. People will receive this honor if someone in Germany thinks that it will enhance German society. And I was thrilled when I heard that someone nominated Krishna, and I was so happy and really excited. And it's an honor that I was not actually aware that it was also being given to foreigners.
I'm receiving this honor for my work as a translator. I've translated some of the major authors of contemporary literature in Germany. Also for my teaching over the years and my work as Fulbright program advisor at Wesleyan. Germany has been particularly good in maintaining the Fulbright program ever since the early years after World War II. And then I've also been the advisor for students who have come to Wesleyan under an exchange program that exists between the state of Connecticut and the German state of Baden-Württemberg. I have sent many students there, and I have received many students who have come here. I feel definitely humbled, but also quite elated, because particularly for translators, honors are few and far between, and to be recognized in this way is really very affirming.
Today, as we are facing a growing tide of nationalism, of ignorance and intolerance, the world needs people like you, Krishna Winston. You were a great source of motivation and inspiration for your students and everyone around you, supporting issues of social justice and the protection of the environment, both causes which are also very dear to any German. For this engagement, you have received the Edgar Becken Social Justice Award. It gives me great pleasure and pride that the President of the Federal Republic of Germany has accepted our proposal to bestow the Order of Merit of the Federal Republic of Germany upon you. Ganz herzlichen Glückwunsch dafür.
Thank you, Krishna, for everything you have been doing, and thank you for being such a good friend.